For company to be able to protect our privacy, they have know how to, how to utilize our data, how to even open data. And if they don't know how to utilize those data, then someone has to by doing that for that loss company. And it led up to another question is there necessary for each and every company, organization to know how to utilize data? We don't, can we have like proxy or agent to dealing with those questions for us? Yeah. 用中文自己讲。这个是跟上面那个一直被刷下去的问题有关的，就是那个如果要大公司有办法，那个保护我们的隐私的话，他必须要有个know-how，知道怎么样去，必须要至少知道怎么样用这些使用这些资料，怎么样子去，甚至保护这些资料。那现在目前为止有多少的公司知道？多少公司或新创知道如何去使用这些资料？这样，有多少比例的这些公司有知道这些怎么样去使用这些资料？这样子，然后，还有一点是，我们真的需要每一间公司都知道怎么样这些资料？我们有没有一个代理或是其他的专门的 startup 可以帮处理这些问题？这样。
Okay, does anyone want to pick up the mic, brothers?I would say GDPR, but...
yeah, perhaps the first question about communication, organization does not use open data and data. Some of the pioneer territory about open data and data participate to a special NGO organization to help other municipalities.To work with data and to open their data. And there are a lot of collaboration between municipality in France to help each other on this, this subject. And the second question,
plus, 第一个的话当然就是关于就是怎么样去教育这样子使用资料或是开放资料的一些方式，其实在法国这边的话，我们有一些特定的一些 NGO 或者是我们市政府这边政府这边都会有来进行处理，然后去看看说这怎么样去应对这样子资料或者是开放资料的部分。那这是第一个部分。那第二个问题是
on the second part of your question about GDPR, There are no personal data on open data in France, of course. And if we want to publish some data that begin with personal data, we have to aggregate this data to anonymize these data just before the publication.So it's not a very big subject. The law and the regulation, the regulation was very clear on that. And perhaps, no, it's okay.
那第二个问题的部分的话，其实在法国这边并没有一个专人或者进行这样子的处理。不过在我们去分享出来这些资料、开放资料的时候，我们都会必定是要把它去做匿名化的处理，然后才能开放出来。那这在我们的法律跟规范上面也是有明定的。
Just a word to complement. It's two kind, different kind of data: private, personal data and open data. But with new data science, some problem could come too, because we could share.An anonymized file of data of transportation with a map of address. And if we see that every one person every night stopped at the same address on the map, we could discover the address, and with the address we could discover the person, and with the person we could discover is a displacement, a movement on with transportation recording. So we need to take into consideration the fact that perhaps the kind of articulation between anonymized and open data set could sometimes bring problems. But for sure, because in France there are people who are very stressed about this question, so they think that we need to lower the number of files that we open to the public because of GDPR, because of public protection and everything like that. We need to take the problem into consideration, but it shouldn't stop the open data movement, in my opinion.
那在这边的话，就是单纯简单的一个评论，就是说，其实个人的资料跟开放资料，他们是两种不同的事情啊。所以在我们就是说讲到说，像运输的部分，我们去看它的模式或者是相关资料的时候，把它放到地图上面的话，当然我们可以去看，就是一般的，就是一种匿名化的经过整理后的的开放资料。但如果是去看到说每个人他在每天可能的一些不同的位置，它一些移动的一些路径的话，其实甚至你也可以借这样子的方式去看到特定的人士他的一些地址种种的。那这样子的话，当然我们要非常的小心，或者是这部分就必须很敏感的部分。那在法国这边，在这部分其实我们一直都很小心很敏感，是因为这会关乎到我们个人的一些隐私的部分跟这些自由的一些影响。
Your second question about whether companies should deal with themselves or could there be other agents to help them is of course a market issue, right? If that kind of company exists, right? And if that kind of company exists, then there's other questions about if they have access to the data collected by the first company, can they actually, how much access can they have, right? Because there could also be other data collection and sharing practices that need to be followed.Right. So you know, it there are two sets of problems there. And 我自己讲没关系，好，可能讲快一点，就意思就不够。那所以就是说，就是他的第二个问题，就是这个公司是不是都要能够自己处理？这当然是一个市场问题，有没有这样子的公司代理这样子处理这些事情的公司存在？那如果有的话，那也有可能就是说那。因为收集资料是第一公司嘛，那他们在什么样情况下可以把资料给第二个公司去帮他们处理？然后第二个公司需要遵守什么样的规范？第一个公司需要遵守什么样的规范？这些都是需要讨论的问题，然后也可能有相关的规定。那另外就是我想要讲的是另外一个问题，就是说your first question about big companies and how they utilize data and like.I kind of wanted to err on the other side because I think the problem with some private companies as I see it, or even government as I see it, is they collect too much data that is not necessary. Like, I often download apps and decided not to use them because they try to ask too much access to my data, and I decided not to use it at all. I think there are some kind of myth that data is absolutely good for them, but actually it could be liability like we were talking about in the first question. When you collect all this data, then you are responsible for taking care of them, right? And so when you collect too much data than you actually need, then you're actually creating liabilities for yourself. So I think it is something we should talk about. Like open governed data, we have a set of rhetoric there saying these are our data, it's our tax money, and you know, you should open data for us and for public decision. So there are a lot of different rationales there, but if it's about private companies trying to collect user data, then it's a very different problem. So yeah, 那用中文很快讲一下，就是私人公司收集个人资料，我觉得是需要小心的。就是其实我觉得有些公司现在是收集过度的在收集资料，他们其实可以少收集。然后因为收集资料不见得是对他们是绝对是好的，因为有时候过度收你收集太多资料，你就是需要对你收集的这些资料负责，跟对这些资料的拥有者负责。那如果说你收集太多资料，其实是给自己增加很多的法律负担。
Okay, we are already over time, more than over time. So I would like to thank all the panelists today for their sharing, and there are a lot of inspirational questions as well from the audience that hasn't been answered yet. So we will communicate online, and perhaps you will comment on some of them, and then we will publish them afterwards. Yeah. So again, thank you all very much. and thank you all for being here. Thank you.
Thank you.
那时间过，那就今天就到这边。那相关的问题，我们或许会在线上再交流，然后讨论完之后，我们会再跟大家分享。那今天就到此这边，谢谢大家。